Hello, this is Prabal Dev. So after we have considered the transformation that F1 through FR minus 1 be denoted by a single block F, we will have something which looks like this. P1 and P2 are plain text of L bits each. They pass through the F block and produce an intermediate text Y1 and Y2, both of L bits. Y1 and Y2 serve as inputs to FR block, which takes in a round key KR and produces corresponding ciphertext C1 and C2. The difference between the plain text P1 and P2 is denoted by alpha, and the difference between the intermediate text Y1 and Y2 is denoted by beta. The difference is found by XORing the bits of P1 and P2 so that we have P1 XOR P1 dash, P2 XOR P2 dash, P3 XOR P2 P3 dash, etc. to give us L bit alpha. Similarly, we have Y1 XOR Y1 dash, Y2 XOR Y2 dash, etc. to give us L bit beta. We suppose that such alpha beta exist with high probability, only then we can mount a differential attack. In order to mount a differential attack on a block cipher, it is necessary to have a differential tail alpha goes to beta with high probability. Let us for now suppose that we have such a tail alpha beta. We will come to how to find such alpha beta later. For now, let's see how to find the key KR for the round FR when we have such alpha beta with high probability. We choose any plain text x1. However, since we want input difference as alpha, therefore we have to choose x2 as x1 xor alpha. Now if we do x1 xor x2, we will get input difference as alpha. We have the liberty to choose x1 because differential cryptanalysis is a chosen plain text attack. Now, what can be the possible values of x1? Since x1 is L bit plain text, therefore it can be any combination of 0 and 1 having L bits. There will be 2 to the power L such numbers possible for x1. Similarly, for x2, c1, c2, y1, y2, alpha, beta, they all will be L bits. The system will output two ciphertext C1 and C2 corresponding to the plain text X1 and X2. In order to find KR, we should note that round keys are N bits. So KR can be anything from 0 to 2 to the power n minus 1. We perform an iterative and exhaustive search on KR. We make a table which will keep the count of each of the possible keys. We select the candidate key KI. The subscript I is an indicative of the decimal representation of the key. So I can be anything from 0 to 2 to the power n minus 1. We perform the inverse operation at FR to get Y1 and Y2. The inverse operation can be an inverse mapping of C1 by Xbox and then bitwise XOR of the result with the candidate key KI. Since we have already considered Fbox to be an Sbox for simplicity, this inverse operation is justified. We have got Y1 and Y2, then we XOR them to see if they output beta or not. Since the differential tail alpha goes to beta exists and we have chosen inputs which have input difference as alpha, it is highly probable to get Y1 XOR Y2 as beta. The only variable factor that decides if Y1 XOR Y2 is beta or not is the candidate key KR. If Y1 XOR Y2 output beta, then we increase the counter by 1 for that particular key KI in the table. We repeat these steps for all such plain text X1. When we have covered all possible plain text for X1, then we choose another key as our candidate key and repeat the process. We do so for all possible candidate keys. Finally, when we have iterated over all keys and over all plain text for each key, we look at the table to find the key with the highest count. The key with the highest count will be our round key KR. In order to understand how to find alpha beta, we look at a simplified version of F and consider F as purely an S box. For our discussion, we will use the following S box as F block. This S box takes in 4-bit input X and produces 4-bit output Y with the following mapping as shown below. The 4 bits are represented as hexadecimal numbers. This table shows some input-output values for the previous S box. If the input is 0, output Y from S box is 14. If the input is 1, output Y from S box is 4, and so on. On the right, we have output difference delta Y, which is beta, and input difference delta X, which is same as alpha. We will have delta X to range from 0 to 15, but we have shown just 3 values of delta X here. If the input difference delta X is 11, we have output difference delta Y as 2 if the input X is 0. Similarly, we will have the output difference of 7 if the input text X is 2, etc. Likewise, if the input difference delta X is 8, then we will have output difference delta Y as 11 if the input text is 0, and so on. If we see the column for delta X is equal to 11, we see that the output difference of 2 has appeared 8 times, and the output difference of 7 has appeared 2 times. Similarly, if we see the column of delta X is equal to 8, we see that the output difference of 15 has appeared 2 times and the output difference of 11 has appeared 4 times. We enumerate the input difference and their corresponding output difference in a table like this. There are a few points to notice here. First, sum of all the numbers in a row is 16, as well as sum of all the numbers in a column is also 16. Remember, we had taken 4-bit number in our S box. The top left corner is 16. This is expected and not an anomaly, because if the input difference is 0, we expect output difference to be 0. That is to say that if the two plain text are identical, then their ciphertext should also be identical. The only abnormal value is 8. It occurs once and is highest among others. Thus, we have found our alpha beta. If all the values are similar with no peak values, then alpha beta does not exist and we cannot mount a differential attack. If this was an ideal block cipher, then all values would occur with the same probability, that is, all values will be 1. So their probability of occurrence will be 1 by 16 each. However, such an ideal block cipher is not possible because all values have to be essentially even. Why? Because if plain text x1, x2 give output difference delta y, then plain text x2, x1 will also give output difference delta y. This is because XOR is commutative. So once we have chosen a value for X1, X2 will be separated from alpha difference. We will have to choose this value of X2 as X1 for another iteration. Thank you.